Good afternoon and welcome to this first lesson on how to start up the Focke-Wulf 190A8 Anton. In this lesson, I will teach you all you need to know to get this aircraft ready to taxi. During the lesson, you will be directed to various controls that you will need to actuate in order to continue the instruction. Let's get started, shall we? Move your control stick and rudder through their full range of movement to make sure your control surfaces are not restricted. Now, request the external electrical power by using the radio menu. Slash, then F8, then F2, and then F1. Press the spacebar when you are ready to continue.
Chief, turn on the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now on.
The first thing we will do is open the oxygen valve by placing your mouse over the knob and rotating your mouse wheel forward. Once you do, you will see the oxygen flow indicator start to blink. Now that the electrical power is attached and enabled, we need to push in the external electrical power CB to let the electricity feed the systems. Now we will check if all necessary circuit breakers were left pushed in by the last pilot. Please open the forward and back circuit breaker covers. Now please make sure that the highlighted circuit breakers are pressed in. Please press them in if not done so already. Now that we have electrical power, check that your fuel tanks are full. The highlighted switch allows you to view fuel quantity in your forward and rear tanks, the center position is off. The amount of fuel in the selected tank is indicated to the left in the yellow indicator. Use your left and right mouse buttons to move the switch. Press the spacebar to continue. The Anton has two magnetos. Using your right mouse button, let's place the magneto switch in the full forward M1+2 position by clicking 3 times on the handle. Good. Now click on the fuel tank selector lever 3 times with your right mouse button to place it in the top open position. This will allow the engine to feed automatically from both the forward and rear fuel tanks. Moving back to the right console, press the highlighted middle circuit breakers. These mostly control the fuel pumps, but also the navigation lights. Let's go ahead and close the canopy now, because it's soon going to get rather noisy. Use your mouse wheel to close the canopy all the way. Press the spacebar when the canopy is closed. On the left side of the console is the throttle. Press Right, Alt and Home to move it to the idle start position. Behind you on the left side is the fuel wobble pump. Use the left mouse button to stroke the pump 15 times. Press the spacebar when done. Open the cover on the starter switch by right-clicking it. Left mouse click and hold in the switch under the cover to allow the flywheel to spin up. Hold it down for 25 seconds. After 25 seconds, release it and hold the mouse over the switch while holding down the right mouse button until the engine start catches and you hear the engine running smoothly. Once the engine is running on its own, press the spacebar to continue. As soon as the oil temperature starts to rise, move the throttle forward to 1250 RPM. RPM between 600 and 1200 can damage the radiator farm drive. This concludes this training lesson.